दिव्या वो सारा सुनाया दे।
मैं सर।
कॉल करी विकी। अच्छा
हाँ ठीक है, करती हूँ।
सर 80 कर लेने।
ठीक है सर, ठीक है सर।
अच्छा वी कैन इमीडिएटली स्टार्ट। सर नमस्कार। विभुदत्त सर।
यस, गुड मॉर्निंग सर, गुड
हाँ
मॉर्निंग सर।
सर नमस्कार। आई एम ऑडिबल।
नमस्कार सर। हेलो,
सर लेट अस स्टार्ट दिस सेशन।
यस, आई थिंक ऑल आवर
ओके।
अदर लर्नर्स आर देयर।
हाँ लर्नर्स आई हैव ऑलरेडी जॉइन।
ओके,
डियर लर्नर वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। प्लीज कीप योर माइक इन ए म्यूट मोड। वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग विभुदत्त सर। डॉक्टर विभुदत्त महापात्र सर। ही इज असिस्टेंट वाइस प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ आदित्य बिरला ग्रुप ऑफ ओडिशा एंड ही लुक आफ्टर कॉर्पोरेट कम्युनिकेशन एंड सी एस आर। आई होप यू हैव ऑल्सो अटेंड टू मोर क्लासेस अर्लियर अबाउट एडवर्टाइजिंग पी आर एंड मीडिया मैनेजमेंट। आई थिंक टूडे इज द थर्ड ब्लॉक ऑफ द सेम टॉप सेम चैप्टर। So today we will go through, I think sir, we will learn today media management.
We'll learn to see, sir.
Yes, CSR and activity related to,
Yes,
linked to media. Okay. Okay.
CSR and media management.
Media management. So hopefully we expect that everyone will join and joining also, and they will enjoy the class. I do welcome also our technical support, Debidatta Behera Abu. Without him, we cannot able to allow the learners. So, sir, it is over to you right now. You can continue.
Yeah, thank you, Vishwabu. Very good morning to all the learners. As I've already told you, today we'll be discussing about the two aspects, the CSR and media management. CSR, as the name itself implies, it is said that corporate social responsibility. If we'll reverse the word, then it will be the responsibility of the corporate towards society. Then a question arises, why the corporate should be responsible for the society? Because since the corporates or the private undertakings, they are only profit motive, and which is a you can say which makes themselves distinct from the government administration or the government undertaking. Because the government intention is welfare motive. It is always CSR related, and it is always having a very philanthropic and welfare motive for the citizens. But private sector undertakings or the corporates, they are mostly profit oriented. And not only that, because since they are drawing profit out of their business in a particular area and from the particular section of the society, in return, it becomes a moral responsibility on their part to give something back to the society. which is called corporate social responsibility. We'll discuss in detail the threadbare, what is CSR and what is exactly these different aspects and what is the present status of CSR right now, and what is the next way forward for CSR, which can be, which is called sustainable development. That we'll be discussing in the first part. Then in the second part, the media management, how media management also is related with the CSR communication, or you can say how media management is required to make the CSR communication more effective and more meaningful, and in fact to bring those news to the doorstep of the people, so that the other people can get benefit out of that CSR schemes of different companies. Before going to CSR in detail, I must tell, I must start with two statement of the two management thinkers. You must be knowing about a very management thinker who is called Warren Buffett. He says that it takes 20 years to build a reputation, but only 5 minutes to ruin it. I think most of you are well aware about this statement, and what this statement says, the statement given by Warren Buffett, that's true. It takes 20 years to build a reputation or a brand, or you can say, or a name for or an image of a company, but only 5 minutes to ruin it. It is how then a question must be arising in your mind, that how it is related to CSR. Yes, it is a CSR which helps you in creating your brand. It is your developmental activities, or it is in fact say what you are doing for the benefit of the people of the society in where you reside, that will culminate in the, you can say, the formation of your brand. But it takes 5 minutes to ruin it. If you are a failure in either executing the CSR activities or falsely propagating it, or not able to propagate in the manner in which it ought to be, then it is a failure on your part, and the company, the image of your company will be ruined. So that is a very important statement which is related to CSR. And another statement also he has given, business should not only be responsible morally to the stakeholders, but also to the society, environment, and towards sustainable planet at a large. It means you can say that, okay, I am doing business I'm dealing with a particular sector. I am dealing with the metal sector, or suppose I'm dealing with a mining sector. Then CSR is not something which you are doing for the only the development of the peripheral people, but what you are contributing to the society at large, because it is that particular section of that area is a part of the entire society. So CSR is nothing about doing a particular development activity in a particular region where you operate. In fact, that is essential, that is a must. But in fact, CSR goes something beyond that. What you are doing beyond your immediate periphery, or what you are contributing to the society or to the planet at a large, that is also called CSR. So again, another definition I must tell you, the basic definition of CSR, which you can find in your booklet, that CSR is the definition given by World Bank, is the commitment of businesses to contribute to sustainable economic development, working with employees, their families, their local community, and society at a large to improve their quality of life in ways that are both for the business and good for the international development. The definition says, and I'm just making it more simple for the understanding of all of you, that CSR is something like, you can say, doing various developmental activities like infrastructure development, like carrying out sustainable development program in the region, like development of women, development of the women, contributing to the women empowerment, and the adoption of different health-related schemes, taking care of the health of the people of the region where you operate. So these are the various aspects of CSR, which you need to do in order to win the confidence of the people where you in the area where you operate. And not only that, it is a part of that, and but also for winning the confidence of the people at large who live in the society. So again, I'll start giving two examples why CSR is required and how CSR is becoming more and more useful with each and every passing day. You must have known about the two incidents that has happened in case of Aditya Birla Group's Utkal Alumina plant in the year 2001 in Maikanj in the district of Raigada. One fire incident happened, and also subsequently that another fire firing accident happened in Kalinganagar in the year 2006. So why I'm giving you the examples of both the cases, because you know, when a new project comes to the a particular area, definitely the people, some people oppose and some people support. If the opposition is more stronger than the supporters, then the project will face many hurdles. So that happened in case of Aditya Birla Group, Utkal Alumina and Tata Kalinganagar. But you see, after the incident, in the case of Utkal Alumina, I think around 17 to 18 years, and in case of Tata Steel, it is around 12 to 13 years. Both the starters, both the plants, both the projects have been executed, and they have been operating in its due space. So how it happened? It is only through CSR that they could be the respective company persons who could be able to win the confidence of the people, and with their consent, only the consent of the people, only they could be able to establish their plants. They didn't, after the incident, they didn't do anything except CSR. It happened in case of Aditya Birla Group, and taking the example of that, Tata also did that. They for the next 5 years after that first incident, post firing and accident, they forgot everything except doing CSR. You know, if you will go by the norm, present norm, there is a present norm that 2% of the profit should be incurred for the for undertaking.
Sir, clear as Sunil. Sir, clear as Sunil. Sound cutty hochi majhe majhe.
Please mute your hello.
My voice clear to anya jagah re asuchi. Kotu kotlo tumhe srishti pradan. हेलो
हेलो सर
हां
सर सर वो संबलपुर पहुंचे सर वो नेट बिल्कुल भी क्लियर सुन
नहीं सर वॉइस ना क्लियर तो साउंड आछि बट एसएमएस साउंड सारंगर प्राय से ठीक है
सर मे बी मोर नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम
हां ठीक है सर यू कंटिन्यू प्लीज आई
पुटिंग माय मोबाइल इन साइलेंट मोड आल्सो देन यू विल नॉट गेट द एसएमएस साउंड आल्सो आई
थिंक यस सर यस प्लीज प्लीज
Okay. So, coming to our discussion, it is only through CSR that you could be able to win the confidence of the people. And again, if going by the norm of that 2% profit expenditure to be incurred for the CSR, if you go by that norm, and if the respective company like Aditya Birla Group and Tata Group would have gone by that notion, perhaps it was not there. And during that point of time, that was not made compulsory. But my point of view is that even I am giving another burning example, even that example was also there. And when the POSCO company had come to set up its plant in Jagat Singh district, if they could have done CSR, that's a different thing. There are different reasons for the failure of POSCO there. But they not undertaking the CSR activities and not taking the people into confidence. That could be also one of the and the failure of the PR also one of the reason of for non execution of that project in that area. So actually they went by that notion ki, okay, we have not yet set up our plant, we have not yet started production, so we have not yet incurred also any profit, so why will spend? But it should not be the logic of CSR. Is something like it should come from your heart. It is a very, you can say, relative concept. It is a very ethical concept. It has to be always proactive. Before someone asks you to do something, to do some developmental activities in your area, if you proactively do that, if you voluntarily do that, then you will be able to win the confidence of the people, and then only your objective will be achieved. So that was also you can say also CSR has to be always proactive. So coming to next simpler definition. If it's a voluntary initiative on the part of a business to contribute to a better society and a greener and cleaner environment. You know, to better society and a greener and cleaner environment, most of you must be knowing that, because you know, to better society means contribution for a better society means living the, you can say, improving the standard, improving the standard of living of the people by developing the different amenities of life, by providing them the all the good infrastructure, by providing them good health care, by providing them the tips to take sustainable development activities. So those are, you can say, different ways in which CSR can be taken up in a particular areas. Besides that, besides contributing to a better society, for a greener and cleaner environment, that means whatever you will be doing, whatever your plant would be doing or your concerned activities will be undertaking, that should be environmental friendly. That should be that, okay, no doubt. I'm giving an example. If whenever a plant is set up, naturally there will be pollution. Naturally there will be, you can say, a release of the smoke from the chimneys. But at the same time, you have to adhere to the CSR norms. You have to, that means not exactly CSR is like that taking up developmental care. CSR also says you have to adhere to the government norms, like the Pollution Control Board has set up a particular height figure for your chimneys. If you are not doing that up to meet up to that level, or you are something considering that beyond that level, whereby the smoke coming out of that your chimney is polluting the environment, then it is not, it is against the violation of the principle of CSR. Because CSR is, it's a whole, it's, you can say it's a consolidated concept. It's a whole concept which includes not only taking up developmental activities, but also adhering to different government norms so far as the environment or the society remains clean or green. Then there are different myths around CSR, which is said that CSR is not for small business. Some of them say that, some of the people also say that CSR is because, you know, only the big companies or the big undertakings are entitled to take up the CSR activities because they are doing much profits. No, it is absolutely a myth. Whatsoever you can do in your little capacity or in your, you can say, acceptable, permissible capacity, you should do something for the society. And it is too expensive. No, it not at all. It is never expensive because if you are depending, I have uttered one, depending upon the permissible capacity of a particular undertaking or a particular organization, your concerned organization can take up the CSR activities. And you know, another myth is there that it is too complicated and technical. No, not at all. Because it is very simple. It is, the concept is very simple. The modes of operandi are also very simple. Hello. Some of them also says that it's not a myth, it's a real thing, hidden thing. I've already told you in the beginning. CSR is not just for charity. You know, I'm taking the case of example of these same two companies which I have uttered. These companies, why they did the CSR to win the confidence of the people? Because, you know, they very well knew that unless until they win the confidence of the people, they are not going to set up their plants in the respective proposed site. So unless until they set up their plants, then how can they earn the profit? So they did the CSR first of all. Then after winning the confidence of the people, then they could be able to execute their plant and they could be able to incur profit. So the always the hidden agenda is behind taking off any CSR activity by the private undertaking. That's why it is called CSR is not just for charity. Because CSR goes beyond charity and requires that a responsible company takes into account all its stakeholders and on the environment when making decisions. So it is all about, you can say, give and take, but it should not be like always, it should not be in the based on the principle of that. The more in that equation, more percentage should go to the ethical aspect, like you give more to the society. Okay, in return you will get the profit out of your conducting your business, but in return you should be proactive. Nobody should tell you that do this, do that. It should be the spontaneity of the, it should come. That's why I have told in the very beginning that CSR is a concept which comes from the heart. You know, at this given scenario, the global pandemic, every company is doing its CSR activities in terms of either providing them financial support to the government health department to undertake such activities, or some of them also they have started preparing, involving the SHGs, the women of the SHGs, you know, where they operate and prepare in the preparation of masks. Some of them also the technical support from the health team, they have also started preparation of that PPE, personal protection equipment. So these, because you know, it's a crisis situation, it's a global pandemic, the COVID-19. Here CSR is not only confined only to the peripheral area, it goes beyond your peripheral area, it goes because it's a global scenario. So as a corporate citizen, as a global corporate citizen, how you are contributing to the society in terms of helping the respective governments to fight with these deadly diseases. So this is about CSR, that should come from your within, that should come from your heart. Then the next is the objectives of CSR. You know, there are different objectives. First is it helps in increasing the business in real terms. I think most of you, I have already explained about this, and most of you will also be able to understand it. The CSR activities of a particular organization, it helps the concerned company to increase its business, because you know, unless until the people or the customers or the stakeholders are convinced, then you can't increase your business. So CSR is a tool to influence them, to convince them, to persuade them. And second is CSR always helps in building up a positive perception about a particular organization. Positive perception must be all must be knowing, because if somebody does not know about a particular organization, it is only their CSR or their, you can say, their and the people-oriented developmental activities which makes themselves different from others, which helps them in developing a positive perception in their minds about that particular organization. And third is risk management. You know, risk management or crisis management, or you can say at times CSR also helps in reducing the crisis or the risk which the company may face. Because if a company is doing a very good CSR activities, and if some crises are happened to them, then people or the stake or the concerned stakeholders or even the media or the government also will not take that company in that, you can say, they will not form any such negative opinion about that if their CSR is good. They might, but if they are not doing any CSR, if they are not doing, they are not giving something back to society, naturally in the crisis gets double. In terms of if you are doing good CSR, your crisis gets up. So it is about, you can say, risk management, and also it preempts any negative reaction. If the people or the concerned stakeholders are having any negative impression about a particular company, it is only through CSR you can preempt their negative reaction about you. And also brand differentiation. Depending upon your CSR activities, depending upon the depth, the extent of your CSR activities, your brand name also gets differentiated. So there are different factors to contribute to the brand, and CSR is one among them. I'm not telling that only CSR contributes to the brand. There are different other activities also, but CSR activity is one among the different contributions to the brand of a particular company. And it also acts as soft power, you know. CSR is a very soft thing. It's a very, as well as you can say, it can be used as a soft power. It can be used as a soft, powerful weapon in the hands of the company to fight against different crises. If it is a crisis against the people, if it is a crisis against the government, if it is a crisis happening with the different media. So at times also, CSR works as a soft power to deal with such crises. Coming to next, you know, the CSR is a management activity, like in the management principles. As you know, you follow, then generally in management activities, four approaches have been followed. First is plan, then do, then check, and then act. And means what in a planning section, you need to analyze who are your stakeholders first. Then consult your stakeholders and take feedback from them. What needs to be there? What needs to be done there? After getting, in fact, after getting the feedback from the stakeholders, you establish your plan of action, set targets, and then the second stage comes do. That means the real execution of the CSR activities. How to execute it in the site level or the you can say your project site. Then while executing, you check the progress, whether the plan in accordance with the plan which you have formulated in the beginning, whether the execution is in line with your plan or not, you check and then evaluate, or you can say the real stage of the CSR. When where your CSR activities were being executed, whether it has been able to achieve your the target you have set, if there is a you can say difference in that, then what could have been done to make it more better. So this is you follow that plan, do check and evaluate approach in the CSR activity, which is the principle of management also. That's why it is called CSR management. And then coming to the types of CSR. One is proactive and second is reactive. You know, I have already explained you about the proactive CSR. Before someone asks, someone means government, before government asks you or the concerned stakeholders or the people ask you to do something in your area, if you proactively do that, that's why I have told you, always I have been repeating this line, that it is a concept which comes from the heart of the organization management. It should be like, you can say, nobody is putting any pressure upon you. You are coming up voluntarily. So it has to be proactive. And then secondly, one is reactive. Reactive, you know, as the government has made it mandatory, as Mr. Vishwab also was saying in the last class, that 2% of the profit has to be incurred for the developmental activities of the people of the particular region. So nowadays, with this enactment of this act, of this 2% profit, now that nomenclature has been changed. Now it has been made no more corporate social responsibility, but it is compulsory social responsibility. That means you have to do that. So it is called a reactive CSR. And then next is, which are the areas of CSR? First is infrastructure development, because you know in a particular inaccessible area where you are before this, going to this area of CSR, and let me tell you about another thing. People also get confused to say R&R with CSR. But R&R is separate and CSR is separate. R&R is, you know, rehabilitation and resettlement. That means when you are going to do something like establishing a project in a particular area, some of the villages, the people have to be displaced from their villages. So first, the government rule says that you need to rehabilitate them and resettle them by establishing another establishment or R&R, which is called in our corporate language R&R colony. So you have to create that ambience, that you have to give them good infrastructure, you have to give them good you can house to live, complete house to live. Then you will be convincing them to shift from their native village to the R&R colony, which will be built up in a nearby area. So it is not CSR. R&R is mandatory, because whenever the people are getting displaced, that is as per the law of the government, that you need to, once you are displacing them, you need to resettle them and rehabilitate them in a particular ambience. That is not CSR. CSR is something beyond that. That means after, while also doing your construction activities, besides R&R, what other activities you have been taking up in the particular area? You know, R&R happens only with the displaced villagers. But there are also different villages who reside by the peripheral area of that particular region. So undertaking CSR activities in those areas, or undertaking development activities in those areas, in terms of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points which I will elaborate now, those are called CSR activities. But that R&R area, taking developmental activities in R&R colony, that is separate. That will come under R&R. And CSR is something which is separate from that. So areas of CSR are infra development, and like providing good roads, providing them electricity, providing them proper drinking water by means of establishing tube wells, taking the government PhD pipelines, or it's not government pipe, it can also privately install the pipelines in the villages, and you can give them the proper drinking water through the pipes like the PhD does for the government. Okay, and then next is promotion of, sorry, second is women empowerment. You know, in a particular section of society, the period when the woman is not empowered, you can say that the society gets empowered. So taking care of the women of the particular region has also become a very important aspect of the CSR activities, like you can say forming SHG, training them how to generate income, how to save, how to undertake themselves in their different livelihood programs. Like I'm giving an example, you can say, I'm just telling you an example. There is a garment manufacturing unit in our Utkal Alumina plant, where the women folk of the area have been trained, tailoring, have been trained to how to stitch the garments, and now they are being they have got jobs. They are doing the same job in that garment manufacturing unit, and you'll be surprised to know that garment manufacturing unit of our unit is not only doing the uniforms, the different other commercial garments of that area, but also it has taken the order from different other companies to prepare their uniforms. That is a classic example of the women empowerment of that area by us. And secondly, not only by that, by forming the SHG, you can also train them that how to identify the different interests and the skills of the particular women folk of that area, and how to engage them in doing such activities which will also earn some income for them, as well as which will make them economically sufficient and economically empowered. And you know, when a woman feels economically empowered, he gets socially empowered also. So it is another aspect. And then education. Education is it's a very powerful weapon for the society. So under CSR activities also, companies take care of the education of the particular, not only the children, but also of the seniors, but also the, you can say, adults, which is called the informal education, sorry, non-formal education. Formal education and non-formal education, you must be knowing about that. So that also, keeping proper coordination with the AWD and Anganwadi workers, or the particular schools of, government schools of, the particular region, the companies also take off the activities of educating the, or partnering with the government to provide better education to the people of the region, to children of the region, in terms of providing them good infrastructure support to the schools, like blackboards, desk and benches, and proper you can by also appointing proper faculty there. If you're not collaborating with the government to take off to adopt any school, and also some of the companies, they have also set up their own school, like our Aditya Birla Group has set up the Aditya Birla Public School in different areas of operation. And I'll give you another example of CSR going beyond its peripheral area. Like if setting of Aditya Birla Public School in the area where our plant is operated, that is mandatory. That is because always say that since our plant is in operation in those areas, so it has become a responsibility on our part to set up schools there. But we have also set up a very good school here in Bhubaneswar. You must be knowing about that. That is also a CSR. So this is, you can say, CSR is something which is going beyond its peripheral villages, or you can say it is going beyond its own area of operation, which is called contributing largely to the society. And then health also, taking care of health also, health activities also is coming under the CSR activities, like establishment of a hospital. It's a long-term CSR, which is called, the example is all these companies have been Vedanta, Tata, and Aditya Birla Group has also set up a good, very good hospitals in the respective areas of their operation, where they can get the people of the area, the inaccessible area, they also get, we can say, multi-speciality healthcare facility there. Like our case, in case of Utkal Alumina, we have set up a Utkal hospital, which is also now being used as a COVID-19 hospital for the people by the government. So, and next is sustainable development. You know, sustainable development is, you can say, is a very, very broad concept which goes beyond CSR. Before that, I will tell you another aspect of CSR. It's called livelihood program. It is under this, the company identifies the different skills and the different interests, area of interest of the particular people in their peripheral areas. They form the groups, they train them. Like you see, the different companies have set up their own ITI training schools. Like the villagers who are interested, the people who are interested after matriculation for different types of service providing jobs, like fitter, mechanic, electrician. In the ITIs also, the private ITIs set up by the companies, they impart training to that. In case the government ITIs there, the companies also partner with them to train the different interested people. And also not only that, after that also, they link themselves to the different companies after which they get job. In this context, I must tell you the very glaring example of our unit, which is called Aditya Birla Skill Foundation. It, what it does, it the Aditya Birla Skill Foundation has set up its unit in different parts of the country, as well as in Odisha also, where its duty is not only to it goes in line with the Skill India program of the Government of India. You know, in Government of India, this under that Skill India program, the different people are being trained free of cost about different trainings. But here, in case of Aditya Birla Skill Foundation, not only we train them free of cost, but also we link themselves after completion of that short term course for 3 months or 6 months. We link them to different other to ours also, and also to other companies, whereby they and get the job. That means after getting the training, they don't have to struggle for the for getting the job. So that is also coming under the CSR activities of providing livelihood programs to the concerned people. And then next is the next word I was talking about is sustainable development. You know, sustainable development is a concept which goes beyond CSR. That means sustainable development is, you have to, we are fortunate enough to live in a society where we have been enjoying the amenities of different amenities of nature. We are enjoying free air, we are enjoying free light, we are enjoying, there is no check on the use of water. If we compare ourselves with our previous generation, they were having enough liberty. But in our case, some sort of restriction has been imposed. So this, I mean to say that we have to do something to renew these resources of nature, whereby it should be sustainable for our next generations. We should think of our next generations. It is not that we should not be selfish, that we only think of our generation. Okay, we have lived up to our life. We have lived, we have enjoyed our life by enjoying all these amenities of nature. But simultaneously, it is also our responsibility to do something which takes care of our next generations. Because the world is not going to extinct in your generation only. So you have to take care of your next generation by doing some sustainable development programs, which will help not only enjoy them a good life, but also enrich their life. Living a life and enriching their life are also different. So to enrich the life of the next generation, we need to do some sustainable development activities. For example, one of them is, you know, plantation. Plantation has to be done on a regular and a continuous basis, which you will agree with me that it is a very essential part for protecting the environment in our society. The extent of the trees are being cut in the name of development, that should not mean that the development should lead to destruction. No, the amount of getting the trees getting cut Similarly, more than double amount of that tree figure, cutting tree figure should be, the more than double of that sampling should be planted. Not only planted, but also to be nurtured, but also to be groomed, like they take up their own safe, till they take up their own safe. So this is about sustainable development, and that is also a very vast concept. I don't want, there's a concept I've explained. And then, you know, here comes the CSR communication. How to inform the, it is about, till now I have discussed about CSR. What is CSR? How CSR activities have been taken up, and why it is necessary, why it is mandatory, all these things. But next we'll discuss how the CSR communication takes place. Suppose you have gone to a place where you do not know about the local alphabets or the local colloquial language of that area where you are planning to set up your plant. In that case, what you will do? So, I mean, howsoever good or best you are in your CSR activities, unless until you communicate what you exactly propose to do or what you have done to the particular stakeholders where your stake lies, then your CSR activity is not fruitful, or you will not be able to achieve your objective. So CSR communication is a must. And to do the CSR communication, you need to do, you need to adopt different strategies. And media management, or I can say media management is a different thing. Media relation is a part of that. I will confine today's discussions of the media management only to media relations. So it is only through media relations your CSR activities can be, can reach the people of your peripheral villages. Like through media, you want, you can communicate what exactly your CSR plan is, what you want to do in your CSR activities, or if any case study is there, if any you have taken up very, very good CSR activities, then you also need to inform the people by a publication of those positive stories, positive CSR stories, in not only in print media, but also in terms of some news capsules in the electronic media, in social media also, where if it is accessible by them. So, and that is one medium. CSR communication through media is one medium. And second is CSR communication on wheels. Like suppose in a very inaccessible or illiterate village, that means in the Mohair, most of the people are illiterate. They are not able to neither read the newspaper, or not able to also get the exactly the feel of from the electronic media, or they do have the capacity to buy that TV to watch it. In that case, you have to take the CSR communication on wheels to their doorstep. Like you have to take the help of infotainment program. And you have to do it in your, you can say, by in the backside of your truck, in the backside of your van, by means of holding an infotainment program, stage show, opera-like program, not exactly opera, but opera-like programs, who, by which you will be able to communicate what you want to say in terms of entertaining them. That is called infotainment program. That means information plus entertainment. So not only infotainment, but also edutainment. Like means you need to educate the people about your activities, about your programs through entertainment only. Then only you can win the confidence of the people. And CSR communication also take the help of communication on wheels to communicate its masses. And also another effect is, the most effective way of communication is one-to-one communication, or you can say oral communication, where you take the help of, that's why in a CSR team, most of the companies, they prefer the local people to include in them, because it is only the local people who can convince their fellow wings about the company schemes and programs. That's why in a CSR team, all the, you can say, the people who are in the execution level, they are all the local people, which it helps the management to, you can say, execute the CSR activities, not only execute, but also to convince the people also. So that's why the CSR team members, they go personally from village to village, the personally meet the concerned villagers, and they try to convince them by directly communicating with them. So that is also another way of CSR communication. So it is about all CSR communication. And now we'll come to media management, which I say is a must for each and every can say company whosoever deals with any such you can say whosoever undertakes any PR activities. The media management is a must. You know, media is a very important stakeholder for the different companies. And in media management, I think I'll divide it into two parts. Second part I'll be discussing in the next class on media management and crisis communication. And before that, the media relation part, let me discuss with you in detail. You know, media relations, I think I have already told you in my last class, it is a very effective tool of PR for external communication. It is the media which communicates about your company's project, not only project, your CSR activities, your all you can say positive news and negative news also to different public. Media management, media relation is a part of media management. Media relations can be divided into three categories. I think I have discussed proactive, reactive, and interactive. My suggestion here is that, you know, the proactive name itself says that your media, proactive media relationship should be up to that level that the situation for reactive media relations should not come. I think you must be getting what I'm saying. That means you have to develop your proactive media relationship in such a manner, with such a, you can say, in a very a positive, in a very effective manner, for which it will not amount to the reactive media relations situation. That means that situation, you should not let that happen. That means your relations should be that stronger, that strong, that you can say, you should have that bonding with the your media person, so that before anything happens, before any negative happens, the media should tell you, the media should communicate you. Because that is the result of the proactive media relations, which every media relation people enjoy. If you are having good relationship, I am again telling you, if you are having good PR, not public relation, but good personal relations, good only when that personal relations will be converted to positive relations, then only your proactive media relations will be more stronger. And if something happens which is not conducive for your organization, these concerned media people will definitely give you a call before writing something. So that is called the different, that is called the real proactive media relations, which will not amount to reactive media relations at any cost. So media management, that is you can say the proactive, reactive, and interactive parts of media relationship are different types of media relations. And why, again, it is not only that media relations is one way, or that means the PR people has always, or the corporate communication people has to always give good relationship with the media. It is a two-way process. Even the media also takes care of the PR people, or always concern the PR people to get number one is the lead for their exclusive stories, the news, as well as not only that, but also the it is through the PR people or the corporate communication people the advertisement gets routed. So for to get the revenue from for their own organization, they also need to be in touch with the corporate people. So it is a two-way process. So but again, I'm telling you, the since it is a two-way process, some of my students also, or some of my colleagues also, they take they often ask me that what should be requirement for a PR people so far as media relations is concerned. So I always tell them, it is a very personal experience, it is a very personal tips which many of you may accept or may not accept. It is my personal view. I tell them that whenever because you know I am also while telling you that I have also come from the journalism background, and I am a corporate journalist and corporate communication professional. So when I made up my mind to join corporate communication or PR, I went to my mentor and asked that what are the qualities needed for a successful corporate communication person. The very first advice of him to me was that since you are a journalist, so you must be having that ego, that every journalist has his own, not only ego, but that you can say that I'm coming into Odia. Moor joda thai, je mu eta likhi debi, mu eta telecast kore debi. Say that factor. So if that is within you, so that you should that your ego, you should keep it in your back pocket. So but after having an experience of more than around 2 decades in corporate communication and PR, I tell to my well wishers or to my the people who take want to take some tips from me, don't keep it in the back pocket, rather throw it in the Bay of Bengal. Because if it is in your back pocket, then you might have that liberty to take it from their back pocket and use it at times. But it is my advice to not to keep it in the back pocket also. Just throw it in the Bay of Bengal. By saying this, I am not saying that you should compromise with your self-esteem. No. Keeping the self-esteem intact, you should not, the PR people should not have any ego. Should not display any ego with the, so far as the media, irrespective of its circulation. It's a very classic example. I'll tell you that people also tell, some of the my PR colleagues also say, they will also agree with me that we give maximum priority to Times of India, but we don't give any priority to any 8 pages local Delhi. But that should not be for a PR people, irrespective of the circulation. Irrespective of its, you can say, reach, you need to give equal importance to all the media persons. You know, you never know if local reporter of Dake Cook or Tentuli Chatter can be more effective than the reporter of Sambad or Samaj. If it comes in your paper and if that negative news is gets questioned in the house, either Vidhan Sabha or Lok Sabha, then you are at... you will be facing very difficult times so far as PR or media relations person is concerned. So my advice is to, so far as media relations is concerned, give good media relations, strong media relationship, proactive media relationship with the media, whereby the situation will not amount to reactive media relations. And so far as this communication is concerned, in terms of CSR or the business news, it is equally the media people also feel that they should also get the information from the company sources. And another tool of you can say media relations is arranging a fam visit. That is family in the short, it is a short form of familiarization visit, where you will be taking the media, leading media. It is an act of proactive media relations, where you will be taking as a corporate communication person or the can say PR person, you'll be taking the leading media journalist, leading journalist of the leading media to your plant site, where you'll be showing them exactly what to deal with, how your plant operates. And so that's a separate set of activities you need to take care of, everything, each and every minute details of their program, like preparing the schedule, to picking them off them from their houses and taking them to the plants, taking care of their accommodation, taking care of their, you can say, plant entire activities during their testing with you, so far as this, that familiarization visit is concerned, and then dropping them at home at after the visit. So the entire process of activities that also comes under media relations, which every corporate communication or PR people, they take care of. And besides that, I again telling you that there is always a hidden objective behind any PR activity, because the very definition of PR is says that you, whatever relationship you are having, whatever positive relations, personal relations, all come to an objective, that is the achievement of a particular objective. So here also in familiarization visit, the objective is to, you can say, you know, there is a saying that seeing is believing. That means whatever you see in your own eye, that is more believable, rather than anybody say, or you go through any other newspaper or any other form of you can say communication. So when you take off, when you take the journalist to their, to your plant site and familiarize themselves with your activities, how you operate, how you you can say you can say how you get your product, every all these activities, what your plants, and when you are addressing them, and when your the head of your organization is will address them at the plant site, then naturally it will bear some extra importance, which the objective is to get good stories being published, being told in the you can say in the through the journalist to whom you take. That means that covering the press release and going, the journalist going to a particular spot and writing good about you, that importance varies from hell to heaven. So there is a vast difference between that. So you need to take care of that also. Not only don't follow up with the journalist, because they also know that once your family, you are taking them to a familiarization visit or farm visit, the ultimate objective behind is to you can say to request them to write good stories about you in the after the visit. So don't follow up with them. They will definitely do because they also know that. So that is also one tool of media relations, which also at times many at most of the time clears the misconceptions which the journalist or the media person, if they are having so, and also it gives a clear picture about what you can say in thousand of words or number of press releases. The journalist can also tell that in by filing different stories about the plants. So that is also an effective tool of media relations. So this is about, I want to I can say I want to conclude with this statement about this media relation, is that if you are having a positive, or you can say, yes sir, if you are having a personal relationship, personal rapport with the media, then it is having a very positive impact, not only for you but also for your organization as a whole. And about the other aspect of media management, or you can say the how these different departments in a newspaper organization function, that we'll be discussing, and also crisis communication, how media also helps in managing the crisis, that we'll discuss in the next class, and another one class I will take. So coming to the end of the session, I must tell that CSR and media management are both essential for corporate communication. You know, and the CSR and the corporate communication are like the two sides of the same coin. Corporate communication gets the material to showcase what exactly the company does in terms of, not only in terms of CSR, but also in terms of project activities. But CSR is nothing without corporate communication. Like CSR is having no presence. Unless the stakeholders, unless the beneficiaries get avail the facility of CSR activities, then CSR is meaningless. So how the beneficiaries come to know about that? It is through CSR communication, or it is through media relations, or it is through the publication of CSR stories in media, that which is the job of the corporate communication. So the CSR and corporate communication, from that point of view, are like the two sides of the same coin, which are very essential for the smooth functioning of the PR department of an organization. And media relation is also an effective tool for PR and also for CSR communication. So with this, conclude my today's deliberation, and now the forum is open for questions. I think a lot of questions are being asked. I think hardly 20, 21 messages are there. So now the forum is open for questions.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. There are several questions.
Not properly audible to me.
Sir, right now it is audible? Is it audible right now? Ha, sir, it is audible right now. Anya manaku mo voice subuchi. Yes, ha sir,
you are audible.
Audible na, okay. Sir Subila. Yes sir, samastam subuchi. Hello,
hello Biswabu, hello.
Ha sir, voice subila.
No, I basically believe Mottiti Sukunodra, that's why I disconnected and again
okay. Yeah. Okay, sir. So nicely, sir has explained about corporate communication, public relation, as well as media management in a single row. That means every organization, they need a public relation department. They right now is they are bound to have a corporate communication organization, which is compulsory from the end of the government. As well as media is one part where they cannot exclude it, because whatever the industry used to do for the people, and people need to know what the company or the organization is to give the benefit and how they can able to look after this periphery development. ମୁଁ ଟିକେ ଓଡ଼ିଆରେ ତାକୁ କହୁଛି ଯେ ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ସାଧାରଣ ଦେଖିବା ଗୋଟେ ବଡ଼ ଇଣ୍ଡଷ୍ଟ୍ରି ଅଛି, ତା ପାଖଆଖ ଅଞ୍ଚଳରେ ଯେଉଁ ଲୋକମାନେ ଥାଆନ୍ତି, ସେ ଲୋକମାନଙ୍କର ସାନିଟାଇଜେସନ୍ ବ୍ୟବସ୍ଥା ହଉ, ସ୍ୱାସ୍ଥ୍ୟ ହଉ, ଶିକ୍ଷା ହଉ, କିମ୍ବା ତାଙ୍କର ପାନୀୟ ବ୍ୟବସ୍ଥା ହଉ, ଯେଉଁଟାକି ମୁଖ୍ୟ ଧାରାର ଏଇ ତିନି ଚାରିଟି ଜିନିଷ, ଆକୁ ସେଇ ପ୍ଲାଣ୍ଟ ନିଜେ ତାର କ'ଣ କରେ ନା ପୋଷ୍ୟ ଗ୍ରାମ ହିସାବରେ ନେଇଥାଏ, କିମ୍ବା ତାଙ୍କର କିଛିଟା ତା ଫୁଲଫିଲ୍ କରେ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟରୁ ସାଙ୍ଗରେ ନେଇକି ବା ବିନା ସାଙ୍ଗରେ ନେଇକି ବି ସେମାନେ କ'ଣ କରନ୍ତି ଏସବୁ ଜିନିଷକୁ କରନ୍ତି। ତେଣୁ ଏସବୁ ଜିନିଷକୁ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଗୋଟେ କମ୍ପାନୀ କରୁଛି, ସେ ନିଶ୍ଚିତ ଭାବରେ ତାକୁ ହାଇଲାଇଟ୍ କରିବ କୋଉଠି ନା ଅନ୍ୟ ଲୋକ ଆଲୋଚନାକୁ ବି ଆଣିବ। ସେଥିପାଇଁ ମିଡିଆର ରୋଲ୍ ଏଠି କ'ଣ ଅଛି ନା, କମ୍ପାନୀ ପ୍ରତି ଗୋଟେ ପଜିଟିଭିଟି ଆସିବାର ଅଛି, ଯେ ଏ ବିଦା ବିନା ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟର ସାହାଯ୍ୟରେ ଇଏ ଗୋଟେ କମ୍ପାନୀ କରିପାରୁଛନ୍ତି। ସେଥିପାଇଁ କର୍ପୋରେଟ ସୋସିଆଲ ରେସ୍ପନ୍ସିବିଲିଟି ୱିଙ୍ଗ, ଯୋଉଟା କି ଗୋଟେ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ, ପ୍ରତ୍ୟେକ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ ଅଣ୍ଡରରେ ରହିଥାଏ। ବେସିକାଲି ଆମେ ଏଠି ଓଡ଼ିଶାରେ ଆମେ ଦେଖିବୁ ଯେ ଇଣ୍ଡଷ୍ଟ୍ରି ମାନଙ୍କର କର୍ପୋରେଟ ସୋସିଆଲ ରେସ୍ପନ୍ସିବିଲିଟି ଆମକୁ ଦେଖିବାକୁ ମିଳୁଛି। ରାସ୍ତା କଡ଼ରେ ଦେଖା ହେଇଥିବ ଟାଟା ଷ୍ଟିଲ ଦ୍ୱାରା ରାସ୍ତାରେ ମାନେ କ'ଣ ଆପଣଙ୍କର ଯାତ୍ରୀ ଆଶ୍ରୟ ସ୍ଥଳ ଅଛି, ବା ସେମିତି ହିନ୍ଦାଳକୋ ଦ୍ୱାରା ଅଛି। କିନ୍ତୁ ଏମିତି କି ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ ସବୁ କମ୍ପାନୀ ଯୋଉଟା କି ଟେକ୍ସଟାଇଲ ଇଣ୍ଡଷ୍ଟ୍ରି ଠୁ ଆରମ୍ଭ କରିକି ଟବାକୋ ଇଣ୍ଡଷ୍ଟ୍ରି ଠୁ ଆରମ୍ଭ କରିକି ଆଲକୋହଲ ଇଣ୍ଡଷ୍ଟ୍ରି ବା ସ୍ମଲ ସ୍ମଲ ଇଣ୍ଡଷ୍ଟ୍ରି ଯିଏ ବି ଅଛି, ନିଜ ପ୍ରଫିଟ୍ରୁ ସେମାନେ କରିବା ପାଇଁ ବାଧ୍ୟ। ସୋ ସାର୍ ହାଜ୍ ଏକ୍ସପ୍ଲେନ୍ ନାଇସଲି, ଆଇ ୱିଲ୍ ନଟ୍ ଟେକ୍ ସାର୍ ଭାଲ୍ୟୁବଲ୍ ଟାଇମ୍, ସୋ ୱି ୱିଲ୍ ଗୋ ଥ୍ରୁ ଦି କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ରାଇଟ୍ ନାଓ। ସୋ ସମୱାନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଆସ୍କିଂ, ଲେଟ୍ ମି ଗୋ ଥ୍ରୁ ଦି କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ସାର୍। ସାର୍, ଇଜ୍ CSR ଇଜ୍ ମ୍ୟାଣ୍ଡେଟରୀ ଫର୍ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍? ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ନାଇସ୍ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍। ଇଜ୍ CSR
हाँ
ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍, ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍ ମିନ୍ସ ମିଡିଆ?
CSR ओके लेट मी टेल यू वन थिंग यू नो CSR आई थिंक व्हाइल डिस्कसिंग द मिथ्स अबाउट द CSR आई हैव डिस्कस्ड इट इन वन पॉइंट दैट सम ऑफ देम से दैट CSR इज नॉट फॉर स्मॉल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और अदर एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन or a newspaper organization. Even coming to your question, CSR is required for each and every organization. No, there is no hard and fast rule that only the big companies or only the manufacturing companies or only the profit making companies will do CSR. Even the newspaper organization also does CSR. Then that is because CSR is a concept which you that is required for you can say not only for the survival of the organization but also for building of the image of the organization. If a newspaper organization duty is to provide news, that does not mean that if they will do CSR and there is any wrong in it. So they can also do CSR which will earn very good image, very you can say positive image for that particular organization. And it is not neither you can say it has been made compulsory, but nobody can say that CSR is not required for any organization or for any even at individual level also. People also do CSR. It is the celebrities, they also do engage themselves in the CSR activities. So CSR is also the newspaper organization can take up. For example, I'm giving you recently Nandigos channel has taken up the responsibility of you can say providing rations and providing these masks and providing the PPEs to the health department and the rations to the needy people. Those news have also come in the different media. That is also a CSR activities being undertaken by that particular news channel. So nobody can, there is no bar, there is no, you can say restriction regarding taking up the CSR activities by a particular organization, be it newspaper organization, be it any type of organization.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. I want to add on that here, sir. ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ଭୁବନେଶ୍ୱରକୁ ଯାଉଛନ୍ତି, ରାଜରାସ୍ତା ଦ୍ୱିପକ୍ଷ ରାସ୍ତା ଅଛି, ଦେଖିବା ମଝିରେ ମଝିରେ ଗୋଟେ ଗୋଟେ ଗଛ ଲାଗିଥିବ, ମଝିରେ ପିଲର ବୁଲା ହେଇଥିବ, ତାର ବାଲି ଚାଲି ଦିଆହେଇଥିବ, ସେଥିରେ ଲେଖା ହେଇଥିବ କୌଣସି ସମ୍ବାଦ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ ର ବୋର୍ଡଟେ ଲେଖିଥିବ। ମୁଖ୍ୟତଃ ସେମାନେ କ'ଣ କରନ୍ତି, ସେଠି ଗଛ ଲଗାନ୍ତି, ପାଣି ଦେବା ପାଇଁ ବି ସରକାରକୁ କୋଉଠି କି ସେ ମ୍ୟୁନିସିପାଲିଟି କି ଦିଅନ୍ତି ପଇସା, ସେମାନେ ବି କଣ୍ଟ୍ରିବ୍ୟୁଟ ଏଇ ବାବଦରେ ବି କରନ୍ତି। ଅନେକ ଅନେକ ଜାଗାରେ ସେମାନେ ଗଛ ଲଗାନ୍ତି, ସମୂହ ଭାବରେ ଗଛ ଲଗାନ୍ତି। गवर्नमेंट टू जगह आणिकी ए बाबद भी सीएसआर पैसा को खर्च करते कहीं मीडिया इज ए बिजी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन तेणु से कौन करते आउटसोर्स कर दिखाते क्या कौ जो मैंने सीएसआर एक्टिविटी करते जो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन तक भी से पैसा दे पारिथे से ये सर अनदर क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज मैक्सिस टेक ऑन मीडिया ओनरशिप मैक्सिस टेक ऑन मीडिया ओनरशिप अजय आर यू देयर अजय राउत
I think I will also discussing media ownership in the media management next class,
yes,
which I have decided the other aspect of media and management. So I'll take up that in
yes,
this
sir.
Question.
Yes, this question.
Yeah.
Then there is
management. Next.
Next question. What do you understand by market media research? Media research कौन को है? कहे माने माने कौन?
Media research. That means you know. Media research again. It is also coming under the media management's other aspect. Besides media research, I'm telling you, I'll be discussing in detail, but I'm telling you about that. Media research is how far your particular media's product, that means whether it is a newspaper or whether it is a channel, how what is exactly how it is being well highly circulated, or can the circulation figures, the you can say the readership figures. The different you can say parts of the areas where your which are being used to get your product. Not only that, your TRPs, all these can be included in media research. And suppose particularly, I mean, also coming to very specific, you are analyzing a particular situation which has been covered in different medias in different shapes. That also comes under media research. So that's a that is. About all these things, but we will be discussing in detail in the other aspect of newspaper management, of which market research, media market research is a part.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you. There is another question, a long question. That is, sir, positive stories are being carried by its own, or it was being paused to published. If yes, then do you feel that the media management is required to showcase positivity of CSR activities? And that means he is asking about that. Do the media organization always shows the positivity of CSR activities?
Yes, I'm telling you. Not only that, that I agree with you that yes, media. If you are having good proactive media relations, then your positive CSR activities also get highlighted. But it is not true always that media only always highlights the CSR positive stories. At times also, media highlights if your CSR activities does not, you can say, fall in line with your the CSR company CSR policy, or it the beneficiaries are not able to get the proper benefit of, out of your CSR activities, or if your CSR activities is limited, it is less, it is not up to mark, then media also highlights that stories also. So there is it is not true that media only highlights the positive stories of CSR stories of a particular company. At times also media highlights the negative stories also, because you know the job of the journalist is to inform the right thing, the true thing about the particular thing. Okay, that's a different thing, because of your managing of your the extent of your relationship will also manage those stories. But that's a
हाँ दीपक सर पटी गली
हाँ सर किसी प्रॉब्लम है चुदे आपने कॉटिंग करो
ओके हाँ सर पटी इतने
ना एक्चुअली आई हैव हैविंग सम प्रॉब्लम इन माय लैपटॉप दैट्स इट कुड गेट कनेक्टेड सो आई हैव टेकन द हेल्प ऑफ मोबाइल
यस सर प्लीज कंटिन्यू प्लीज आई विल आई थिंक द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन what does IDCA formula used in media sector and how means
come again
AIDCA means this model AIDDA model IDCA not AIDA model
AIDA model.
Yes, yeah, that is attention, interest, desire and action.
Yeah,
means this is a model prepared in around 1800 because whenever your organization required something, you need to be attend, or your yes. attention is required, your interest is required and desire is required. ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ କୌଣସି ଗୋଟେ କାମ କରୁ ଆମର ଇଚ୍ଛା ନଥିବ ସେଠି ହାପାଜେଟଲି କାମ କଲେ ତା ରେଜଲ୍ଟ ନିଶ୍ଚିତ ଭାବରେ ନେଗେଟିଭ ଆସିବ ବା ତା ଦେହରୁ ଫ୍ରୁଟଫୁଲ ରେଜଲ୍ଟ ଆସିବନି ଆଉ ସେଟା ଆକ୍ସନ ଓରିଏଣ୍ଟେଡ୍ ରେଜଲ୍ଟ ହବ ଯେମିତିକି ଆମେ କହିବା ଆମେ ଗଛ ଲଗେଇ ଦବା ଆମେ ଗଛ ଲଗେଇବାର ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ କରିବା ଆମେ ନେଇ କୋଉଠି ଗଛ ଲଗେଇବା ନା ରାସ୍ତା କଡ଼ରେ ଗଛ ଲଗେଇବା ରାସ୍ତା କଡ଼ରେ ଗଛ ଲଗେଇଲେ ଗୋରୁ ଖାଇବେ ତ ଆମେ ସେଥିପାଇଁ ତାର ବାଡ ଲଗଉଛନ୍ତି ଗଛଟାକୁ ଗୋଟେ 2 ବର୍ଷ 3 ବର୍ଷ ମାନେ ତାକୁ ବନ୍ଦ କରିବା ସୋ ୱି ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ମେକ୍ ଏ ପ୍ଲାନ୍ ୱି ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ମେକ୍ ଏ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଟେଜି then this particular model has to be fulfilled every work ei jo particular public relation ei part ta ba you can tell this is also advertising part also whatever the thing is you need to do for the society means this model tell that you need to always look out that you put your attention man seti prati sabu bol mane gote gacha ta lagai dela hobani gacha ta bada hoy ki chhai hai ki loko ta par kahibe na gacha ta ke lagaitla na ye lagaitle ei organization that till that date you need to put your action so that is a long term process that the model has a long term process to fulfill your achievement so this model used to work okay there is another question role of public relation in developing countries
okay I'll come to again this question role of PR in developing countries just after this just to add what you have said earlier na AIDA model the CSR is a glaring example of this AIDA model of communication you know unless until I've already told you the very beginning that CSR is something which you should come from your within which that means if you are not so keen so interested to do to take up such activities then you cannot ever you cannot do that sort of activities so you need to be passionate so that passion need to come from your within which is this CSR activities is a glaring example of this AIDA model of and coming to the another question role of PR in developing societies yes that's a very good question you know we are
developing countries sir
developing countries, I mean, yes.
Yes
yeah so first of all you all know the objective of PR or the objective of PR people and you also know the nature of developing countries where your all your can say the indicators of development are in a very transition phase neither you are down the line nor you are above the line so you are in between that is the trend of developing countries so here the role of public relations is you can say has become more important more enormous because you know they are the real bridge between the organization and the people and here they also should take the example of the developed societies and they should communicate about what has been happening in the developed societies which the developing countries should practice in order to go to that taken off level so they are in the taking off level they are neither in the land nor in the you can say the taken off level they are in the you can say just land just taking off level so in that level you need to understand that what are the indicators required to take your plane to that taken off level and here the role of the PR people has becoming more important they need to be well versed with not only with their present situation of the developing countries in which they reside but also they take the example of the developed societies and also they should also look into the you can say the characteristics of the underdeveloped countries that should not also they should not you can say they should not communicate such things which the country should go to even that level also so they should be always they take you can say better examples you can say better they should publish better human interest stories they should take the examples of classic examples of the developed societies and propagate that to the people of the developing countries or societies
okay sir thank you there is a question government policies and media management are related there is a question mark if yes what is the effect of media ethics
government policies and media management
See, media management are related when they are interlinked Okay, his question is then, what is the effect of media ethics? This he's in linking this question. I want to answer this one, sir. You see, media has its own role. ଆମେ ଯେମିତି କହୁଛୁ ଯେ ଆମେ କ'ଣ କରିବା ଦରକାର କ'ଣ କରିବା ଦରକାର ନାହିଁ, କିନ୍ତୁ ମିଡ଼ିଆ ତାର ଗୋଟେ ଗାଇଡ଼ଲାଇନ୍ସ ଅଛି, ନିଜର ସୋ ଗାଇଡ଼ଲାଇନ୍ସ ଅଛି, ଯୋଉଟାକି ସିଏ ସୋସାଇଟିକୁ ଦଉଛି ଆଜ୍ ଏ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍, ଆଜ୍ ଏ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେସନ୍, ଆଜ୍ ଏ ଇନ୍ଫର୍ମେସନ୍ ଏଭ୍ରି ଟାଇମ୍। ସୋ ଏଥିରେ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ପଲିସି ଆଉ ମିଡ଼ିଆ ମ୍ୟାନେଜମେଣ୍ଟର ରୋଲ୍ ତା ଦେହରେ କ'ଣ ଆସିଲା? ମିଡ଼ିଆ ମ୍ୟାନେଜମେଣ୍ଟ ହେଲା ମିଡ଼ିଆକୁ କେମିତି ମ୍ୟାନେଜ୍ କରାଯିବ, ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ପଲିସିଜ୍ ହେଲା ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟକୁ କେମିତି ତାର ପଲିସି ୟୁଜର୍କୁ ମିଡ଼ିଆ କେମିତି ଡେସିମିନେଟ୍ କରିବ ବା ଇନଫର୍ମ କରିବ। ତ ଏଥିରେ ତାକୁ କିଛି ଆଫେକ୍ଟ କରୁନି ବା ମିଡ଼ିଆ ତାର ଏଥିକ୍ସ କହୁନି। ହଁ, ବେଳେବେଳେ ଯଦି କୌଣସି ଗୋଟେ ପଲିସିଜ୍ ଉପରେ, ଯେମିତିକି ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ କହିଲେ 20 ଲକ୍ଷ କୋଟି ଆମେ କ'ଣ କରୁଛୁ ନା ଲୋକଙ୍କ ପାଇଁ ବିନିଯୋଗ କରିବୁ, ସେଇଠି ମିଡ଼ିଆ କ'ଣ କରୁଛି ତା ଉପରେ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ମାର୍କ କରିବ ଯେ ଏ କେମିତି ହବ ବା ଆର ଗୋଟେ ଆନାଲିସିସ୍ କରିପାରିବ। ବଟ୍ ହିଏ ଡଜଣ୍ଟ ମିନ୍ସ ଟୁ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେଟ୍ ଇନ୍ ଇନ୍ ଆନାଲିଟିକାଲ ୱେ ଇନ୍ ଦ ପଲିସିଜ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦି ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ଦାଟ କମ୍ସ ଅଣ୍ଡର ଦି ମିଡ଼ିଆ ଏଥିକ୍ସ, ମିନ୍ସ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଗୋଇଂ ଏଗେନ୍ଷ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଦି ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ। ଓକେ, ଅର୍ ୟୁ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ୱାଣ୍ଟ ଟୁ ଆସ୍କ ଇନ୍ ଏ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ୱେ ମିଷ୍ଟର ସିଦ୍ଧାର୍ଥ ବଳିଆର ସିଂ, ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଆସ୍କ ଇଫ୍ ଦ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ସାଟିସ୍ଫାଏ, ଦ ଆନ୍ସର ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ସାଟିସ୍ଫାଏ ୱିଥ୍ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଆୱର୍ ଏଣ୍ଡ, ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଆସ୍କ, ଅର୍ ଏଲ୍ସ ଆଇ ୱିଲ୍ ଗୋ ଟୁ ଦି ନେକ୍ସଟ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍। Someone is asking what is CSR, corporate social responsibility, samajik daitya bodhata, mane kahara samajik daitya bodhata, konosi industry ra, konosi bada organization na, je ki gote corporate ba je ki gote private sector hochi ba public sector hochi samastankar। Someone is writing what is corporate social investment,
same, that means for social development what you are doing, same thing, that means the for the development of the society what the corporate are investing and what the corporate are spending.
Yes sir, yes,
yes.
Ajay Raut again is asking DAGMR model. I think Ajay, it was discussed in the last class, okay, but that is about advertising class, so I don't think so we should repeat it again and again. Hello,
yes, yes, yes.
Then how to organize media fam trip, somebody is asking, so mu gote tar example debi kemiti media fam trip organize kara jae। ଯେତେବେଳେ ପୋସ୍କୋ ଓଡ଼ିଶାକୁ ଆସିଥିଲା ସେତେବେଳେ ପୋସ୍କୋ ପ୍ରତି ବିରୋଧାଚରଣ ଆସିଥିଲା କିଛି ବିରୋଧୀ ଦଳ ମାନଙ୍କର, ଯୋଉଟାକି ଓଡ଼ିଶାରେ ସେତେବେଳେ କଂଗ୍ରେସ ବି ଥିଲା, ତାଙ୍କର ବିରୋଧ ହେଇଥିଲା, କିନ୍ତୁ କଂଗ୍ରେସ ସେଣ୍ଟରରେ ଥିଲା, କଂଗ୍ରେସ କହିଥିଲା ଯେ ପୋସ୍କୋ ଏଠି ହଉ, ଏବଂ ଓଡ଼ିଶା ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ କହିଲା ଓକେ ୱି ଆର୍ ଆଗ୍ରି ଟୁ ଡୁ ପୋସ୍କୋ, ବଟ୍ ତମେମାନେ ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ କ'ଣ କର, ମିଡ଼ିଆର ପାର୍ଟି ବନ୍ଦ କରିବାକୁ ପଡ଼ିବ ବା ମିଡ଼ିଆକୁ ତମକୁ ନିଜ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରୋଲକୁ ନେବାକୁ ପଡ଼ିବ, ଗୋଟେ ଭଲ ପବ୍ଲିକ ରିଲେସନ୍ ବଢ଼ାଇବାକୁ ପଡ଼ିବ। ଏଇଠି କ'ଣ କରାହେଇଥିଲା, ପୋସ୍କୋ ପୋସ୍କୋ ଗୋଟେ ଫ୍ୟାମ୍ ଟ୍ରିପ୍ ଆରେଞ୍ଜ କରିଥିଲା, କୋଉଠି କି ନା କୋରିଆନ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରି, ଯୋଉଠି ନର୍ଥ କୋରିଆ କି ସାଉଥ କୋରିଆ ମୁଁ ଭୁଲି ଗଲିଣି, ଆଇ ଥିଙ୍କ ସାର୍,
ହଁ
ହଁ ସିଓଲକୁ। ସୋ ଦିସ୍ ଫ୍ୟାମ୍ ଟ୍ରିପ୍ ୱାଜ୍ ଆରେଞ୍ଜ ବାଇ ଟେକିଂ ଫ୍ୟୁ ମିଡ଼ିଆ ପର୍ସନ୍, ମିନ୍ସ ଇନ୍ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଇଚ୍ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍, ବିଗ୍ ବିଗ୍ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍, ଦେ ଗିଭ୍ ଆନ୍ ଅଫର୍, ମାନେ ଫ୍ଲାଇଟ୍ର ଅପ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଡାଉନ୍, ଷ୍ଟେଇଂ ଆରାଉଣ୍ଡ 3 to 4 days ଓଭର ଦେୟାର ହ୍ୱାଟ ଏଭର। ଆଟ୍ ଦାଟ ଟାଇମ୍ ଆଇ ୱାଜ୍ ଏ ସ୍ଟୁଡେଣ୍ଟ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ଅଫ୍ ମାସ୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେସନ ଷ୍ଟୁଡେଣ୍ଟ, ଆଇ କମ୍ ଟୁ ନୋ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ମାଇ ଟିଚର୍, ଆଣ୍ଡ ମାଇ ଟିଚର୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ୟୁଜ୍ ଟୁ ମୁଭ୍ ଟୁ ଦେୟାର ଅଲ୍ସୋ। ଦେନ୍ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ହ୍ୟାପେନ୍, ଦେ ମୁଭ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ସି ହାଉ ବ୍ୟୁଟିଫିକାଲି ଦାଟ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର କମ୍ପାନୀ, ଦାଟ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ପୋସ୍କୋ ଇଜ୍ ୟୁଟିଲାଇଜିଂ ଦି ସେକ୍ଟର ଆଟ୍ ଓଭର ଦେୟାର, ବଟ୍ ୱିଦାଉଟ୍ ଲେସ୍ ମ୍ୟାନ୍ ପାୱାର, understand that, without manpower. And what happened after this trip has been arranged, these people come back and write many extraordinary articles in the favor of POSCO, but few of them are very much concerned about the state of Odisha, because Odisha is such a state where the people are very poor, and they get every each and every industry get in a cheaper price of labor to run the industry. For because of this particular information used to go, then some media organizations also think that yes, POSCO is not related to Odisha, should not come. Some tell that it should come. You see, farm trip can be arranged. Farm trip is very costly and very renowned or famous organization or industry can arrange this farm trip. So it is up to the CSR department, or not CSR, public relations department, could able to arrange a farm trip. So I have given an example and how to arrange when you will work in a public relations sector, when you will work in a industry, then you can understand. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, please.
While discussing the farm trip, I have told in a very nutshell, right? It's a very set of activities, a very wide range of activities, starting from picking up the journalist from your their houses, and again taking them to either through flight or through train or through giving them in their comfort zone, taking to your site, showing them exactly what you do, how you operate, with in which way your plant is different from others, what unique pictures you do have, all these things, and then again picking them off from the plant and dropping them at their respective houses. The entire range of activities are covered in the pantry, and it is the responsibility of the PR team of that concerned organization, and the very objective is to acquaint the journalist in your area of activity where you operate. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes. Thank you, sir. Yeah. And Siddharth Shankar Behra is asking, thanks, sir, for the wonderful session. I'm not asking. It is clear, CSR and media organization. So I think everyone is clear. If anyone is having any question, they can verbally ask.
Hello, sir.
Pradeep Tehotas.
Hello.
Again.
Sir, good morning, sir. Sir, my question is, sir has beautifully explained that CSR is that is a social responsibility for all the citizens and all the organizations. But my question is, as it is compulsory, so what should be the minimum turnover for a company to come under CSR scheme?
CSR fee, I'm just forgetting. There is an amount. I think I'll check with the figure. I think the company which is having a turnover of 5 to 8 crore, and whatever profit is being incurred, the 2% of that profit has to be mandatorily expensed. But exactly 5 to 8 crore is what I guess. But I'm not sure. I'll check with it.
Okay. So earlier it was the profit was 1 crore. It has increased, and tenure was 5 years.
I'm talking about the turnover, not profit amount. I'm 2% yes, of the sir. Profit amount mandatorily incurred. But I'm talking about the turnover of the
turnover. Yes. Yeah. Earlier the time period was 5 years from the company set up. 5 years now might have been minimized, but I am not sure. I have not gone through CSR. New rule or amendment rule?
That figure is, I think, the turnover is that, but whatever profit, even suppose, listen, our group is a very, like, I'm giving you the example, why the POSCO failed. I'm just coming to explain in Odia. POSCO failure, however, but the CSR come dispensable, they fell in it. पूछो तो देखो लेने माने कौन माने माने सीएसआर का माने कोलेने काहे की ना माने स्टैंड्स ले कि अब तो अपन तो प्लांट ही है कोनो प्रॉफिट ही ना अबे काहे की सीएसआर करूं सो दैट इज अ वेरी माने रीजन फॉर देयर फेलियर So at that point of time, it's a big company. She is somebody who can try to make a profit. But that, but the minimum that you should be, that the company or whatever, how profit is incurred for you. That 2% has to be mandatorily incurred for this CSR activities. I think it was rupees 5 to 8 crore in the beginning, and I'm not sure about the changes there. If there is, next.
Sir, more out question, Dila. That is. So, as I belong to Kalinga Nagar area, so maximum industrialization is there. So my point is, jodi konosi company properly CSR activities karu nathanti, tale whom should we lose the complaint?
Acha, mu ei gude kotha bolna, bolo bolo kotha pachale, gude koi douji, mu gude kohiya ko discussion kala bi bhuli uthili, gude RPDAC committee hoche, bujhle? Sabu industrial belt re RPDAC committee hoche, regional peripheral development assessment committee. Okay. So that committee consists of the representative from different companies, as well as the government authorities, as well as the political representatives. So in that RPDSC committee meets twice in a quarter. মানে তিনি মাসের ভিতর মিটিং হুয়ে অ্যান্ড অলসো ডিপেন্ডিং অপন দি নিড দে দি ফার্দার মিটিং ক্যান অলসো বি অ্যারেঞ্জ সো ইন দ্যাট মিটিং মানে আইদার ধর আপনার কমন লোক অনেক আপন থ্রু ইয়ার পলিটিক্যাল রিপ্রেজেন্টেশন অর থ্রু অ্যাজ এ পিটিশনার আপনার যাই সে ইয়ে আপনার যে মিটিং আরপিডিএস যে কনভেনর থাকবে আপনার যাই সেটি আপনার গ্রিভ্যান্স দিয়ে পারবে যে অমুক কোম্পানি এদিও এত প্রফিট করছে এত অপরেশন অনেক সিএসআর কাম করবে তো দ্যাট কোশ্চিন ইজ বিং ডিসকস ইন দি আরপিডিএস মিটিং ইটসেল্ফ যদি বি সেটা আরপিডিএস মিটিং রে সে কোন যে চেয়ারম্যান থাকে আইদার কলেক্টর থাকে অর সব কলেক্টর থাকে সে নেসেসারি ইনফরমেশন দিয়ে টু দি কনসার্ন প্রেজেন্ট অফিসিয়াল ফ্রম দি কনসার্ন ইন্ডস্ট্রি তারপরে বি যদি ন হলা দেখেন ইউ নো মিডিয়া হেল্প ইজ দেয়ার মিডিয়ার স্টোরি বাহারে নেগেটিভ স্টোরি বাহারে মিডিয়ার নেগেটিভ স্টোরি বাহারে কি হুয়ে ইফ দি অ্যাসেম্বলি ইজ ইন সেশন ইট অলসো গেট ডিসকাসড মিডিয়া রিলেশন কু সমস্ত সবুড়ে মুখ্য মানে ইম্পর্টাণ্ট টুল হিসাবে মানে পব্লিক রিলেশন গ্রহণ করতে তো সেইটি আপনার মানে মিডিয়ার স্টোরি বাহারি যদি আসেম্বলি ডিসকশন হল সেইটি কোম্পানি তো দিজ আর অল দি ডিফরেন্ট এক্সপ্লেন মানে রুটস বাই হুইচ দিস দিস ইউর গ্রিভান্স ক্যান বি হোয়াট ইউ আর টকিং অ্যাবাউট দ্যাট ক্যান বি
হ্যালো
Yes, am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, Bishop, nala kon dole lekhi thebe apan koi thun.
Next question is somebody is writing RPDASC meeting is organized at difference of 1 year nowadays with availability of RDC sir and others. So my answer would be at here.
Yes,
you can. My answer would be at here.
Hello.
We can file. Yes, we can file a RTI, Right to Information Act. ओटे RTI मागी परिवार कहाँ को collector को जे अम्मो अंचोले जो अच्छांती organisation बोली का से माने CSR activity केते पैसा खर्च करो चंदी. कहेंगे ना कौनो सी कामो कले भी से माने कौनो सी अंचोले. সেমানে সরকারক অনুমতি মাগিবে কোটি স্কুল ঘর পাই ডোনেশন দিয়ন্তু বা স্বাস্থ্য পাই ডোনেশন দিয়ন্তু বা সেমানে নলকূপ খোলন্তু বা কোনোসি ফেরিফেরি র ডেভেলপমেন্ট পাই কিছু বি করন্তু দে অলসো হ্যাভ এ ফিগার অর ডাটা দি ইন্ডাস্ট্রি দে ডু হ্যাভ এন্ড দে গিভ টু দি লোকাল অ্যাডমিনিস্ট্রেশন দ্যাট মিন্স টু দি ডিস্ট্রিক্ট হেড অর ইউ ক্যান অ্যাস্ক টু দি কালেক্টর অ্যাবাউট দি এক্সপেন্সেস স্পেন্ড ওকে
taken care, then that will also take care of your grievance.
Private company mane RTI re asunanti kintu ame collector ko pacharchanti collector hochanti government ra. Okay, Siddharth Shankar Behra, any other question? So let me conclude the session. Thank you, sir, Dr. Bibhudatta Mahapatra, sir, being with us. This is the third class which we have successfully conducted. And student might have gone through the SLM as well as the verbal classes, online virtual classes. And I also again want to thank the learners to attending the classes. Next of all, I want to thank Devidatta Babu.
Sir, are you able to listen? I have a question.
আচ্ছা কোশ্চিনটা কুহ নহলে কোশ্চিনটা লেখ আর ইউ গেটিং মাই পয়েন্ট আই হ্যাভ এ কোশ্চিন কইলে কে আমি দি বুঝিবো আমি
ইয়ে ইটস ওয়েদার সিএসআর ইজ আর ইউ এবল টু লিসেন আপন শুনি পড়ছন্তি
ইয়েস ইয়েস নাও আই এম ইট ইজ অডিবল টু অল অফ ইউ আই থিং টেল মি
ইয়েস স্যার স্যার ওয়েদার সিএসআর ইজ ম্যান্ডেটরি ফর all the organization, even small or big, or there is any parameter for CSR? That is the question.
If there is a parameter, that means the turnover of the companies which is not exceeding that amount, you are not, this is, CSR is not binding upon you. Okay, but if your turnover is beyond that amount, you are bound to incur some amount, you have to allocate some amount for your CSR, that is 2% of your profit, and that parameter is 2% of your profit. So, but it is not exactly, it is not mandatory for the small players. But again, as I have told you, to earn the goodwill, to earn the image, you need to do CSR proactively on your own. Hello, Bishop. Hello. 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 Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. There is some problem in my audio.
Okay.
Okay. I might have there some in our book also. It is written 1,000 turnover per annum. Okay. This would be criteria, or you can go on searching Google. Recently, the Act, Companies Act. Industrial Act or Companies Act might have written.
I'll take the clear figure and I'll let you know the next class. Yes. Okay. I'll get the concrete figure.
Okay, thank you very much, everyone present over here. Thank you, Devidatta Babu. And again, I want to thank you, Bibudatta, sir. So let us end the session right now. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody.
Sir, namaskar.
Namaskar, 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 sir. Sir, namaskar.
Bibudatta, sir, namaskar.
Bibudatta, sir, namaskar.
Sir, shuni parujanti.
Apana kiye kouchanti?
Sir, sir, sir.
Hello. Sir, apana, hello.
Hello.
Sir, good question thila, sir. Good question thila. Hello.
Hello.
Upon hello.
Sir. Hello. I got
good question message related. Hello.
Question.
Sir, question the message related, sir. Hello.
Hello. I'm challenging question. This is what I'm doing.
Sir. Hello.
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 Sir, namaskar.
Namaskar. Bibudatta, sir. Namaskar, sir.
Hello.
Namaskar.
Hello.
Sir, what question thila, sir? What?
Sir.
Hello.
Sir, class is over right now.